Where do big reef fish go to hide, especially from threats such as overfishing and pollution? The Academy's Hudson Pinero has found that in many cases, the fish head to deeper waters, to an area of coral reefs known as the Twilight Zone. Hudson calls it a refugium.
The refugium hypothesis, like, it predicts that, like, mesophotic reefs, like the Twilight Zone, can work as an area where bigger fish are most commonly found there. It preserves some fish and species that can contribute to the recovery of the shallow water fish.
But the Brazilian scientist has found that it depends on how close the deep reefs are to shore and to human populations.
Because the platform shelf of Bermuda is very long, the human impacts that happen more close to the coast don't reach these deep reefs that are situated far from the coast. And in Curaçao, the deep reefs were very, very close to the coast, so the human impacts were much likely to reach these depths.
Armed with this information, Hudson and his colleagues can help protect all of these areas.
In some works that we did in Brazil, we found that many of deep habitats were not inside current marine protected areas. So we start to propose the expansion of these protected areas. In Philippines, we recently presented our data set for the local managers there and show the importance to preserve these deep fish. And now they are planning to expand the marine protected areas there too. So in different areas that we visit, we are trying to send our data as fast as we can to the managers and try to work together with them in order to answer these questions or fill some gaps of information and try to expand the actual marine protected areas for these deep reefs as well.